is going to be on why parents do not make good Christmas presents. There's something that these guys have in common. They were given up for different reasons. Having a parrot is a very personal decision, and it should not be made by anyone except for that person that is going to be spending the rest of their life with them, because it is one of the biggest commitments you will ever make. Parrots will be with you forever. Children come and go, and then they sometimes come back, and then they go, and then sometimes they don't leave. But you can get rid of them if you really wanted to. There's a sanctuary in Arizona with 900 parrots and growing called the Oasis Sanctuary. 900 parrots. Oh my goodness. Just think how many of those parrots were Christmas presents. I think that is definitely a red flag when there's a sanctuary with 900 plus parrots that something is wrong with having these guys as pets. I mean, they're here, so we have to take care of them. And I just want you to know that they are a lot, and I mean a lot of work. When you have a bird, it becomes a big part of your life. It's not something that you can put outside, throw food at it once in a while, and say, hey, how you doing? No, these guys become your companions. They are a full-time job, and that's a huge responsibility to put on a child. Yes, it's probably, you know, good to teach them responsibility, but a parrot is not where you want to start. Many of you are probably thinking, oh, I'll get them a parakeet or a cockatiel. Well, I'm sorry to say that cockatiels and cockatoos are the number one birds that are given up. You guys, they're given up by the hundreds. So cockatiels probably too aren't a good starter bird. I don't think there really is a good starter bird, because whatever bird you choose, it is a huge, and I mean a huge commitment. If you are thinking about making a parrot a gift, let me tell you a few things. There is no guarantee that that bird is going to choose the individual that that gift is going to go to. Parrots choose their people, and that's a big, big thing. Victoria Cockatoo, I never wanted a cockatoo. They're loud, they scream, they bite, they destruct everything. I mean, these guys are a lot of work, but she chose me. She chose me to care for her and take care of her when I first saw her. And she was just going to be a rescue, where I was gonna help her get better and then I was gonna find a home for her. Well, she chose me. And we fell in love, and it was like unbelievable. Look at her. She's amazing. She's amazing. Somebody gave her up. Somebody neglected her. Somebody didn't treat her right. Can you believe that? But it happens because lack of education. Parrots, they're adorable when they're babies. You know, you're probably going, oh, I saw this bird in a pet shop and oh, so sweet. It loves to cuddle. I hate that word, by the way. It loves to cuddle. It loves my kids. It's just the sweetest little thing. Well, they grow up. They become sexually mature. They bite. They scream. They poop. Parrots are crazy. Kids grow up. They go to college. They play sports. They have activities. And that is a huge thing. You do not want to choose a pet that requires almost 24-hour care. I mean, these guys are a lot and a lot of work. My experience from being a teenager and having a parrot, which was a huge responsibility, I just feel like I just want people to know, you know, I wasn't able to go out. I did not party. I had to come home. Now you're probably thinking maybe a parrot is a really good idea for your kid. Actually, my parrot kept me out of a lot of trouble because I had to be super, super responsible. But it was a huge commitment for a young person, and I'm glad I did it. Ouch! And it's not for everybody. Maui! You have a loud bird. Victoria's not loud, but many cockatoos are. I've seen it where they'll put them in a closet because the noise is so bad because you got neighbors yelling at you, or you might have a child that's trying to sleep, or an elderly person living in your home with a hearing aid, and that is no joke. People that have to wear hearing aids, when you have a parrot, such as a caique, that can hit the highest screech you can imagine, that makes that hearing aid, like, literally explode. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you, Maui. So, you really need to take in all the factors of what's going on in your home. If it is something that your whole family is on board with, bringing a parrot into your home, I would like to suggest volunteering at a sanctuary or parrot rescue. Fostering one of those birds. That is the way you really, really can get familiar with having a parrot. Although every bird is an individual and every bird acts different in a different environment. You might take a bird that is quiet in one environment, place it in another, and the bird becomes loud. So that's something that we also can see in rescue. So it's important to really do your research. And if you can foster one of these amazing, amazing birds, do so because it's really good experience for you and your children. I hope you found this video fun and educational. Thomas, how did we do? It's hard filming with caiques, you guys. I know I say it like in every video. Like, literally. Oh my gosh, I don't even know what I filmed. I was just like, oh, but if you found this video fun and educational, I can't believe I just did that on camera. Actually, I do. You kind of go nuts. You go nuts a little bit after having parrots for 24 years. So that is also something to consider. Do you want your children to end up like me, with poop in their hair, just basically talking to themselves? It's not good, you guys. It's not good. But I love it. And it was the right decision for me. So if you found this video fun and educational, please like and subscribe to our channel. You want to say goodbye, Victoria? Give a kiss? Oh my gosh. Parrot Playhouse, and please adopt. It is so awesome.